Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome to our Online Learning Initiative Ekalaiva.
Now let us discuss compound microscope. A compound microscope is an optical device used to see magnified images of tiny objects. A good quality compound microscope can produce magnification of the order of 1000. This compound microscope, which consists of two convex lenses of short focal length, which are arranged coaxially at the ends of the two sliding metal tubes. So here we have two convex lenses. One is the objective lens. So this is the objective lens. And this one is our eyepiece. Actually, this objective lens, which has short focal length. So, objective lens whose focal length is small. So short focal length. And small aperture. And this objective lens, which is placed near the object to be magnified. So here is our object, that is AB is the object. And this objective lens, which is placed very close to this object. Okay. And we have one more lens, which is called as eyepiece. Okay. And this eyepiece, which has focal length comparatively larger than the focal length of the objective and also larger aperture. Okay. So we can very well say that the focal length of the eyepiece is greater than the focal length of the objective. And this objective, which is placed near the eye for viewing the final image. Okay. And the distance between the two lenses, that is objective lens and eyepiece, can be varied by using rack and pinion arrangement. Okay. So this is about the construction of compound microscope. Now let's see it's working. So now let us consider, we know that this object AB is our object, and which is placed at this point, that is the distance between the objective lens and the object is U. Okay, and this object, which is placed slightly larger than the focal length of the objective. Now let us consider FO be the focal length of the objective, but the object which is placed slightly larger than its focal length. And this objective, which forms the real inverted and magnified image. So AB is our object and A dash B dash is the image formed by the objective lens. Okay, so here is the place where we got this image, that is which is the real inverted and magnified image of the object. Okay. And the separation between the objective lens and the eyepiece, okay, that is this separation, the separation between the objective and this eyepiece, which will be adjusted so that the final image, that is this image, the image formed by the objective A dash, B dash, which lies within the focal length of the eyepiece. So we are adjusting the distance between the two lenses such that this A dash, B dash, which will be formed within the focal length of the eyepiece. Okay, so this is the actually focal length of the eyepiece. But the image which is formed here, that is A dash, B dash, that is which will be formed within the focal length of the eyepiece. And this image, that is A dash, B dash, this a dash b dash which acts like an object for the eyepiece. Okay, and this eyepiece which actually acts like a simple microscope. Okay, and this eyepiece which forms virtual and magnified final image. So this is the virtual and magnified final image. Magnified final image. Okay, and this final image, that is a dash, a double dash, b dash, is inverted with respect to AB. Okay, so this is about the working of the compound microscope. Okay, so how many lenses we have, children? Two lenses. One is the objective lens, and another one is the eyepiece. The focal length of the objective lens is very short and also small aperture, but the focal length of the eyepiece, which is slightly greater than that of the objective lens. And here AB is the object, and A dash B dash is the image formed by the objective lens, and A double dash B double dash, which is the image formed by the eyepiece, and this eyepiece which acts like a simple microscope. Okay, now let us find what is the magnification produced by this compound microscope. Okay, so in order to calculate that, let us consider, that is MO, which is nothing but the magnification due to the objective. Okay, so the magnification due to the objective is h dash by h, and already you know that what is this h dash, which is nothing but size of the first image, and this h, which is nothing but a size of the object. Okay, and fo, which is nothing but the focal length of the objective. This is equal to l by fo. Okay, and we know already that what is tan beta, also we know. So what is tan beta? This tan beta is equal to h by fo, or else we can also write it as h dash by l. So what is this l? This l, which is nothing but the distance between the second focal point of the objective. So here you will have the first focal point of the objective, but here you will have the second focal point of the objective. Okay, so this l be the distance between the first second focal point of the objective and the first focal point of the eyepiece, and this is called as the tube length. Okay, so what is this l? Tube length of the compound microscope. Okay, tube length of the compound microscope. Okay, now let us find what is the magnification due to this objective. Okay, and already I told you that this eyepiece which acts like a simple microscope, so the magnification produced by the eyepiece is equal to, when the final image is formed at the near point, what is the formula? 1 plus d by fe. Okay, so then the total magnification will become, okay, the total magnification. What is the total? How will you calculate the total magnification? Actually, total magnification m is equal to mo into me. Okay, so you can write that, already you know what is mo, that is what is mo, which is nothing but magnification reduced, magnification due to objective. Okay, so can you write it as L by FO into 1 plus D by FE. This is the final image formed at the least distance of distinct vision. So I'll write here. When the final image is formed at the least distance of distinct vision, least distance of distinct vision. So this will be the total magnification. Okay. Now, let us find when the final image formed at infinity. Okay. So when the final image is formed at infinity, then what is the magnification due to eyepiece? You will get D by FE. So if this is the case, then the total magnification is equal to again MO, that is magnification due to objective into magnification due to eyepiece. So the formula will become M is equal to L by FO into D by FE. So this is the case when the final image is formed at least distance of distinct vision, then the total magnification is L by FO into 1 plus D by FE. But when the final image is formed at infinity, then the total magnification. So this is M is the total magnification. Okay. Total magnification. When the final image is formed at infinity, that is M is equal to L by FO into D by FE. What is this L? L is nothing but the tube length of the compound microscope, that is the distance between the second focal point of the objective and first focal point of the eyepiece. Okay. To achieve a larger magnification of a small object, the objective and eyepiece should have small focal length. Okay. So actually in practice, it is very difficult to make the focal length much smaller than 1 centimeter. Also, large lenses are required to make this tube length large. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you, students.